Hello students, very good morning. Myself Rakesh Yadav. I am representing Sandipani Higher Secondary School, Rajoda. I am your maths teacher, of course, and we are proceeding with our chapter quadratic equations. Up to 4.1 we have finished, and 4.2 also two questions we have done. Now we are proceeding with third question. But before this, remember one thing, that you should have to subscribe, like and share our channel Sandipani Higher Secondary School, Rajoda, and your feedback is of course required. Now let me tell you this exercise 4.2, question number 3. Here question is, find two numbers whose sum is 27 and product is 182. So here we have to assign, first of all, in solution, let first number is equal to x, then what will happen? Then second number is equal to 27 minus x. It is well clear from here, because the sum of two numbers is 27. So let me explain you one example. Suppose two numbers we have considered, x plus y, that is equal to 27. So if we consider one value as x, then another will be y, that is 27 minus x. So this is another value and this is first value. It is first number, it is second number. So first number is x, then second number is equal to 27 minus x. What we have to do now? Here it is clearly mentioned, find two numbers whose sum is 27 and product is 182. You can apply one more trick. X, if we add x and 27 minus x, then what will happen? This x will be cancelled. 27 will be the result. So sum of these two numbers is should be equal to 27. Sum of these two numbers should be equal to 27. Or sum of these two numbers is 27. So, according to question, product is equal to 182. Product means what? Product of first and second number. So that's why we have to multiply these numbers. X into 27 minus x is equal to 182. This is the product of these two numbers. X into 27 minus x is equal to 182. So 27x minus x square minus 182 is equal to 0. We may take minus sign common from here. So x square minus 27x plus 182 is equal to 0. We may write it like this. Why we are taking minus sign common? We are making the coefficient of x square positive. So if we take minus sign common, then this negative term will be positive term, this positive term will become negative term, and this negative term again become positive term. One more thing that also you have to remember, you have to write these variables in the descending form of their powers. First of all, x square, then x, then without x, means x square, x quantity and constant quantity, because it is our standard form of the quadratic equation that I have told you in my previous lectures. So x square minus 27x plus 182 is equal to 0. Now what we want to do here? You may solve it by that formula method, you may solve it by factorization method, you may solve it by making perfect square. So let us proceed with factorization method. Suppose 182 factors we want to do, what will happen? 2 9s are and 2 1s are. 7, because it is not divisible by 3 also, it is not divisible by 5 also. 7 we are applying, 7 1s are 7, 7 3s are 21. And here it is 13 1s are 13. What happens? 7 2s are 14 and 13. 14 plus 13 is 27. 14 plus 13 is 27. That's why we may write it x square minus 14x minus 13x plus 182 is equal to 0. See, minus 14 and minus 13 is minus 27. And if minus 14 is multiplied by minus 13, then the result will be 182. That is factorized already. 13 and this is 14. So 13 into 14 is 182. And minus 14 minus 13 is minus 27. Now x is taken common. Remaining terms are x minus 14. Here minus 13 is taken common. Remaining terms are x minus 14 is equal to 0. So x minus 14 we can take common from here. So the remaining terms are x minus 13. Here it is x and here it is minus 13 is equal to 0. Means two values can be possible here. X minus 14 is equal to 0 and x minus 13 is equal to 0. This is the rough part. So x is equal to 0 plus 14, that is 14, and x is equal to 0 plus 13, that is 13. If x is equal to 14, what happens to second number? First number is equal to x is equal to 14, then second number is equal to 27 minus x is equal to 27 minus 14 is equal to 13. If first number is 14, then second number is 13. If we have considered first number 14, then second number 13. Or if we take first number is equal to x is equal to 13 according to our second answer. So it is our second answer. Make here two ticks. So for second answer, first number is x is equal to 13 and second number is equal to 27 minus x is equal to 27 minus 13. 27 minus 13 is of course 14. So here secondly if we considered first number as 13, then second number will be 14. If first is 14, then second is 13. If first is 13, then second is 14. So in this way we can find solution of this question. Now our question number 4 of this exercise 4.2 only. Find two consecutive positive integers, sum of whose squares is 365. So in solution, let us consider first integer. Let first integer is equal to x. Then second integer is equal to second consecutive integer, you may write, that will be second consecutive integer you should have to write here, because there it is mentioned, find two consecutive positive integers. You may write positive also. So let first positive integer, positive this symbol you can write, then second positive integer, second consecutive positive integer is equal to x plus 1. What do you mean by consecutive? Let me explain. That's why I have written it in this manner only. Consecutive means, suppose one number we have considered 2, then second consecutive number will be 3. Consecutive means one after the another, one after the another. If I have considered first number x, then another just after x, what will come? X plus 1. Suppose 2 I am considering. After 2 what will come? 2 plus 1. So in place of 2 we have assigned here x. So x and x plus 1 are 2 consecutive positive integers. Now what we have to do? See, according to question, see, what we have to do? We have to do that, read this question in a very proper manner with full concentration, otherwise the question will become wrong and solution will become wrong. So find two consecutive positive integers, sum of whose squares, this part we have considered, sum of whose squares is 365, means square of x plus square of x plus 1 is equal to 365. This we have to do. So we may write x square plus 2x plus 1 is equal to 365, because a plus b whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. In place of a, what is there? In place of a, x is there. In place of b, 1 is there, where a is equal to x and b is equal to 1. So it will become x square plus 2x plus 1 minus 365 is equal to 0. This 365 we have taken it in LHS, so sign will be changed. Now this will become x square, that is 2x square plus 2x minus 364 is equal to 0, because 1 minus 365 is negative 364. We have to subtract 1 from 365 and we have to apply minus sign here, because bigger number is this one. So now take 2 common from here. After taking 2 common, x square plus x minus 2 under 2, 2 8 the 16 and 2 to the 4 is equal to 0. 2 under 2, 2 8 the 16 and 2 to the 4. This 2 will become the denominator of RHS. So then what will happen? X square plus x minus 182 is equal to 0 upon 2, that is 0 only. So it will be equal to x square plus x minus 182 is equal to 0. Now what we have to bring here as a sum 1 and as a product minus 182. See, let us do the factors of 182. 2 9s 18, 2 1s 2. Here, 7 1s 7 and 7 3s 21 and 13 1s 13, that we have done in our previous question also. 14x minus 13x will be positive 1. See, it is 14 and this one is 13. So we may write here x square plus 14x minus 13x minus 182 is equal to 0. So if we take x common from here, x plus 14. If we take minus 13 common from here, it will become x plus 14 again, because both the signs will be changed here. We have taken negative sign common is equal to 0. So if we take x plus 14 common from here, then x minus 13 is equal to 0. Now x plus 14 is equal to 0 means x is equal to minus 14. This is x is equal to minus 14, because if we transpose this positive 14 from LHS to RHS, it will become negative. This answer is not possible. You have to mention the reason also there. X is equal to minus 14 is not possible because in question it is given integer is positive. You write here, because not possible because integer is positive. This answer is not possible. Now we have to take another one. X minus 13 is equal to 0. So x minus 13 is equal to 0 means what? X is equal to 0 plus 13, that is 13. So x is equal to 13 is the correct answer. First, positive integer is equal to x is equal to 13. Second, consecutive spelling I have written here. Second, consecutive positive integer is equal to x plus 1 is equal to 13 plus 1 is equal to 14. So these are the conclusion. 13 and 14 are the result for this question. These are two positive consecutive integers. Look at our another question. It is question number 5th. The altitude of a right triangle is 7 cm less than its base. If hypotenuse is 13 cm, find the other two sides. So let me tell you first of all that in solution, make one figure here first of all. It is perpendicular, or altitude we can say. This is also called perpendicular. It may also called altitude. Suppose I am taking this base x, then altitude is 7 cm less than its base. So this figure is not considerable. Why is it so? Because if I am taking this part small, but smaller is this one, because it is 7 cm less than base. So we have to make it in another manner, this triangle, like this. Suppose I am taking this x centimeter, then it will be x minus 7 cm. And here it is 90 degree. It is triangle ABC. So now each and everything is well clear. Hypotenuse is 13 cm. This is the diagrammatic representation of the solution. Now, if base is equal to x centimeter, then altitude is equal to x minus 7 centimeter. Because it is given in centimeter, that's why we are assigning it in units of centimeter. Now see, what is base? It is BC. And what is perpendicular? It is AB. So assign it BC and AB also, because triangle ABC is right triangle, because triangle ABC is right triangle, we may apply here by Pythagoras theorem. Therefore, by Pythagoras theorem, AB square plus BC square is equal to AC square. See, AB square plus BC square is equal to AC square. Perpendicular square plus base square is equal to hypotenuse square. Means the square of hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides in a right triangle. It is only the Pythagoras theorem. So AB square means x minus 7 whole square plus BC square means x square is equal to AC square means 13 square. It is given 13 centimeter. So we may write it now. X square minus 7 to the 14x plus 7 square is 49 plus x square minus 169 is equal to 0. See, x square minus 14x plus 49. Why is it so? A square means x square. 2ab means 2 into x into 7. So minus 2ab means minus 2 into x into 7. 2 7 the 14x. Plus b square means 7 square, that is 49 plus x square minus 169, because we have taken it from RHS to LHS or transposed it from RHS to LHS. So here you have to mention that formula, because a minus b whole square is equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square, where a is equal to x, b is equal to 7. So it will equal to x square plus x square is 2x square, both are positive, minus 14x. It is negative and this one is positive, so we have to subtract 49 from 169. If we subtract 49 from 169, then what will be the result? 9 minus 9 is 0 and 6 minus 4 is 2. So 120 minus 120 is equal to 0. Now we have to factorize it. Let us do factorization of 120. But before that, if any term is common, see that equation in a proper manner. If any term is common from here, you may take it common. 2 is common throughout. We can take 2 common from here. So if we take 2 common, then it will be x square minus 7x minus 60 is equal to 0. Now, it will be x square minus 7x minus 60 is equal to 0 upon 2. That is x square minus 7x minus 60 is equal to 0. 12 5s are 60 and 12 minus 5 is 7. But here we have to apply minus 12 plus 5 because it is negative. So x square minus 12x plus 5x minus 60 is equal to 0. You may do it by factorize process also, factorization also. 60, 2 30, 2 15, 3 5, 5, 1. See, 2 to the 4, 3 are 12. This is 12 and it is 5. Why negative 12? Because it is negative. Why this one is negative and this one is positive? Because minus 12 plus 5 is only minus 7. And why this one is negative? Because if we multiply this minus 12 with this plus 5, then it will be negative 60 only. So, according to all these conclusions, we come to know that we have to write it x square minus 12x plus 5x is minus 60 is equal to 0. Now, take x common from here, it will be x minus 12. Here, 5 is common, so it will also be x minus 12 is equal to 0. We may write x minus 12 common from here. So, the remaining terms are x plus 5 is equal to 0. So x minus 12 is equal to 0 or x plus 5 is equal to 0. So x is equal to minus 5 is not possible because it is negative. You may write here because negative. Side can't be negative. So it is not possible. X is equal to 12 is possible, 12 centimeter. So this is our base. So what we conclude? We have to find the other two sides. Therefore, base is equal to BC is equal to X is equal to 12 centimeter, and altitude is equal to AP is equal to x minus 7 is equal to 12 minus 7 is equal to 5 centimeter. So we found all, both the values here in this question. Only we have to find the other two sides. So this question is over. See our last question now of this exercise. Question number 6 of exercise 4.2. A cottage industry produces a certain number of pottery articles in a day. It was observed on a particular day that the cost of production of each article in rupees was 3 more than twice the number of articles produced on that day. If the total cost of production on that day was rupees 90, find the number of articles produced and the cost of each article. So, in solution, what we have to consider? See, first of all, we have to consider number of articles, because number of articles, twice the number of articles and three more than that, we have to consider later. It is the cost. So, let the number of articles is equal to x, then cost of each article is equal to, see, cost of each article was 3 more than, 3 more than means plus 3 we have to write later in afterwards part, 3 more than twice the number of articles means 2 into x, twice the number of articles, 3 more than twice the number of articles, 3 more twice the number of articles. See here, 3 more twice the number of articles is the cost of each article. Now, total cost of production is equal to rupees 90. Total cost of production is equal to 90. So, what we have to do? We have to do number of articles into cost of article, cost of each article. Is equal to 90 is the cost, it is given. So we have to multiply number of articles with cost of each article. Number of articles x means you come to understand by this example. Suppose you are having 5 chocolates and cost of one chocolate is 5 rupees, then what you want to do, that 5 is multiplied by that another 5, then 5 5 is 25 will be the total cost. If 5 chocolates are there and if cost of one chocolate is rupees 2, then 2 into 5 will be the 10, will be the result will be 10, means the cost of 5 chocolates will be 10 rupees in that case. So here cost of production, total cost of production is equal to 90. So number of articles is multiplied by cost of each article, then it gives the result 90. So x into 2x plus 3 is equal to 90. Now this will become 2x square plus 3x minus 90 is equal to 0. 2x square plus 3x multiplied here, and this 90 is transposed from RHS to LHS, then it will become negative 90 is equal to 0. Then 92s are 180. This I have told you that coefficient of x square should be multiplied by that constant, that is 180. So 180 we have to factorize, 290, 2, 45, 3. 1s are 3 5s are, and 3 5s are 15 and 5 1s are 5. What happens here? We have to bring here 3. How it comes? 9 4s are 36, 9 5s are 45, 2 2s are 4, 3s are 12, 12 and 15, 3. 3 5s are 15 and 3 4s are 12. 15 and 12. See, plus 15x minus 12x. So 2x square plus 15x minus 12x minus 90 is equal to 0. So x is taken common, 2x plus 15. Now minus, what will be common here? 6. So 2x plus 15. Because 15, 6 are 90. Here negative sign is taken common. So both the terms will become positive in bracket, is equal to 0. Now 2x plus 15 is taken common. Then remaining part of the equation will be x minus 6 is equal to 0. So 2x plus 15 is equal to 0. Means 2x is equal to minus 15. And x is equal to minus 15 by 2. It is not possible. Not possible. Why is it so? Number of articles can't be negative because result is negative. Number of particles